Immigrants. Who are they? Where did they come from? Why did they come? From every direction and continent they came, answering Miss Liberty's call. Send me your tired, your poor, your huddled masses yearning to breathe free. She lifts her lamp beside the golden door, and from the teeming shores, the wretched refuse came like hungry mosquitoes to the yellow porch light of freedom. This week on The Immigrants, The Hillbillies. And now your host, Gregory Puck.
From every hillside in Europe, discontented hillbillies voice their dissatisfaction with living overseas. From Switzerland.
I don't like it here in Switzerland.
The pants are too short.
Yeah, and those frog skiers coming over the hills causing trouble.
The cheese got holes in it.
And hell, I'm a Baptist. I don't want to guard no Pope.
Yeah, in America they got cheese in aerosol cans.
From France.
I don't like it here in France. Everyone's so snotty.
Yeah, I can't read the menus.
And everything here is so expensive.
In America, you don't have to dress up, and you can get Levi's real cheap.
From Italy.
I don't like it here in Italy.
I'm tired of sharecropping grapes.
Yeah, and losing our land to those big olive oil barons.
Yeah, I got six little bambinas and a fat mama mia. And I can't hardly make it on the lira iron here.
Yeah, and here you can't get no D-I-V-O-R-C-E.
And so the Great Migration began. Throughout Europe, the roads were choked with hillbillies from every country.
Howdy. Going west?
Yep.
Where you from?
I'm from the Urals, out Russia way.
The Urals? I got some kin up there. Do you know the Fedeyevich family?
Yeah, Natasha Jean's a good friend of mine.
She is? Well, she's my cousin. Well, where you headed out west?
America. I hear the streets are paved with coal.
Yep, it's true. And they got showers and real good telephone service, too.
From such diverse seaports as Southampton, Rotterdam, and Marseille, they embarked on the arduous sea journey that would cost some of them their lives, and many their lunch.
Hey, strap that mattress to the side of the ship.
All right, Paul.
Grandma, you ride up on top.
On the top?
Mm-hmm.
In dark, dank, smelly steerage compartments, they huddled through the voyage, confiding in each other their pitiful hopes and dreams for the new land.
Boy, I'm going to love it in America. I hear they got eggplants the size of your head. I'm going to pick me up a whole armload of eggplants and squash them all over my face. I'm going to hit myself in the head with big aubergines. Oh, yeah, I'm going to roll around in them.
Eggplants the size of your head?
Yep, and they got goiters as big as eggplants.
Why, they got heads big as your goiter.
And eggs the size of headplants.
I'm going to get me a 56 Ford and put it up on blocks right on my front lawn.
I'm going to get me a pickup truck and drive up and down the main street as long as I like.
Yeah, and they got fine schools there, too. You can go right on up through the first grade.
Not me. I'm just going to hang around bus stations, spitting and picking my nose.
Oh, and there's lots of old refrigerators for the kids to play in.
Say, friend, you want to move that fuzzy duffel bag so I can sit down?
That's no duffel bag. That's my daughter, Fuzzy Mae. But you can sit on her just the same.
Hey! Knock off that whispering down there and keep rowing, or I'll crack this whip till your necks turn red.
Redneck? What kind of cracker's that?
The hazardous journey was made even worse by the choking dust storms that plagued them every nautical mile of the way. After 2 long days at sea, a sharp-eyed hillbilly lookout with bad teeth sighted land. But didn't think it was important enough to mention.
Hey, we're sinking.
What?
Women and children first.
We're sinking.
Unstrap that mattress.
What?
Hand me that fuzzy duffel bag.
Oh, we're sinking.
And so as their ship slowly sank in New York Harbor, the happy hordes of homely, humble hillbillies hot-footed hillward. But first, a short stop at Ellis Island, where helpful immigration officials welcomed the new arrivals.
Hey, you, Slimeface, you're next.
Oh, me?
Yeah, race?
Hillbilly.
Country of origin?
Italy.
Name?
Name's Michelangelo Buonarroti.
Well, what kind of moniker is that for an American? From now on, you're MC Boone.
Hey, you just stamped my hand.
That's so if you go out, you can come back in again.
Oh, I see.
Next, name?
Claude Debussy.
Hey, Boone, wait.
Huh?
We got your duffel bag.
Oh, come on, fuzzy mate.
Debussy, you're Clyde Devons.
Having completed processing, the friendships made on shipboard ended as they headed for their different destinations.
Say, taxi!
Where are you headed?
Paris Island.
I'm headed for Fort Leonard Wood.
Fort Knox for me.
I'm going to Lackland Air Force Base. Say, you mind if I strap my mattress to the side of the taxi? Grandma, you ride up on top.
On top. You coming, Lem?
Nope, not me. I'm just going to hang around this here bus station, spitting and picking my nose.
Well, if you're going to sit on that fuzzy duffel bag, don't be flicking boogers on it.
And so they traveled, first into the heartland, and then into the heart of America, where their contributions are woven into the fabric of American culture. Hush puppies, rickets, rotten teeth, mental retardation, goiters, incest, genetic inferiority, black lung disease, fender skirts, cancer of the lip. The list goes on. And of course, who can forget those noteworthy Americans who proudly call themselves Hicks, Crackers, Rednecks, Hillbillies, Minnie Pearl, Gomer Pyle, Andy Griffith, Robert and Jim Mitchum, Patsy Cline, Buddy Ebsen, Buddy Hackett, the Hills Brothers, the Bond Brothers, Julian and Gary U.S., Arthur Hillbilly Gene King, Mel Torme, the players and coaches of the Miami Dolphins, Billy Graham, Tex Ritter. And that's when I woke up.
Next week, on The Immigrants, The Albinos, The Pale Pink-Eyed People.